Aloha. Hello. Big day. Today, I have the greatest honor of nominating two extraordinary individuals for our Supreme Court. Both are nominees for the associate positions in the court, and I want to say a few things about them and then let them tell their own stories. But before I do that, before I name our two individuals, I want to also say that the selection committee, the judicial selection committee, did an excellent job. They gave me six names for these two positions, which were exceptional. All six people were stars in their own right. All of them have carried themselves in an extraordinary fashion throughout their legal careers, many of whom are on the bench. So I think they are terrific people, and I highly expect that the individuals who we don't actually name today, I expect those individuals to, in the coming months and years, to very likely be on our list and actually nominated for subsequent court positions, some in the near future. So I'm going to give you the names right now of our two nominees. First nominee, Lisa Ginoza. Second nominee, Vlad Devens. These are our two nominees for the associate justice positions. Now, let me say something about each of the other four individuals, because I really do want to honor them. Judge Kupaoda Summer, an extraordinary advocate. I was touched by her work on evictions. I was touched by her compassion for the people that she grew up with. And her experience was actually exceptional and extensive, in spite of the fact that she was significantly younger than the other five nominees. A great person. I expect her to rise in the court system. Judge Nakasone, who is currently an ICA judge. Again, I was touched by her and her commitment to family, and she is such an asset at the court she is in presently. They would miss her terribly if she were to leave. Again, an exceptional judge right now. Judge Clyde Wadsworth, an intellectual beyond measure. His thoughts and comments spoke volumes about his commitment to the state of Hawaii. Has had an extensive career, many years on the bench, and I just really appreciated his candor, but his intellectual capacity and the opinions that he made were extraordinary, just like the other judges. And then Judge Remigio, her story of her upbringing, in addition to her compassion for people, stood out amongst the nominees I've had over the many opportunities we have had to put judges in the bench or advancing them. I think all four of these individuals merit advancement over time if they choose to go forward, and I was really touched by their applications and how great they are as people. I only got to choose two people today, and so now let me talk a little bit about these two extraordinary individuals who I hope will be confirmed by the Senate later this fall, in the next, say, about 30 days. These are amazing nominees. So, Lisa Ginoza and Vlad Devens. As many are aware, my guiding principles are this. The nominations have to ensure diversity beyond just gender and race. It's also background and experience that I was looking for to balance the court carefully this time. These two nominees have very different legal backgrounds, and it was their diversity and depth of experience that served as the most compelling reasons to select them, though they're also just great human beings. They also told extraordinary stories of their upbringing, and I appreciated that. Their experience, though, did stand out to balance this court. The two vacancies are for the retirements of Justice Wilson and Associate Justice Nakayama earlier this year. An interesting fact about these two justices, they are both, or not justice nominees, they are both products of our public school system. They attended public universities also for undergraduate work and then law school. It really was extraordinary to see that be a part of their background. They maintain the balance, it is true, of men and women will be essentially 50-50 still. And it is also true that as we go through the confirmation for Judge Ginoza, we will then have to fill her seat when she is confirmed, knock wood. And that would be for the chief position of the Intermediate Court of Appeal. So as you can see, these exceptional people that I wasn't lucky enough to pick this time should strongly consider looking at these positions. They are leaders in our state. Justice Ginoza, you went to Kailua High School, went to Oregon State thereafter, and then went to UH for law school. I love the fact that individuals are products of our community, our society. Judge Devens, or hopefully soon to be Justice Devens, has been in private practice, and his extensive labor experience was important to me. We have a great deal of individuals that are in the in labor and public workforce, and I really like to see that additional perspective for our court system. So it was terrific to see the diversity of these two individuals. Lisa, as the leader and chief of the ICA, I'll tell you, she had so many recommendations from colleagues. If I may, it was almost impossible not to consider her after that much input from her peers. Vlad, who is known for his pigeon-laced intellectual opinions, brought a freshness to the process. And I really appreciated the ability to have a choice from an exceptional list that wasn't only people who are currently on the bench. I thought that was an addition to this process. So the Judicial Selection Committee was great. They placed both Mr. Devens and Ms. Ginoza on both lists for us to choose from. And that was also testament to how strong they were as applicants. So this is my chance to say to the state of Hawaii, I think we have two exceptional new leaders coming to the Supreme Court, provided that they do well with our Senate colleagues who we have great respect for. The process will play out over the next several weeks, and by statute it has to be completed, I believe, by about the 23rd of November. So we will see this in the near future. And then these two individuals will be followed by perhaps a replacement for Judge Ginoza, which very likely will set off a domino effect of other people to be considered for these important positions. So if I may, I will pause there and take questions afterwards, but I'm just grateful to have such great people that have been nominated.
Mahalo, Governor Green. Next, I would like to introduce to you Associate Justice nominee Lisa Ginoza. Ms. Ginoza graduated from the University of Hawaii William S. Richardson School of Law and most recently served, as you've heard, on the Intermediate Court of Appeals for more than 13 years, with almost 8 as an associate judge and more than 5 years as chief judge. Of her long list of accomplishments, Justice nominee Ginoza is a member of the Board of Directors of the Judiciary History Center and American Judicature Society. Please welcome Justice nominee Ginoza to the podium.
Good morning, everyone. What a great honor it is to be here this morning to receive Governor Green's nomination to the Hawaii Supreme Court. I'm very thankful and grateful to the governor for his confidence in me, and I thank him for this wonderful opportunity that he's bestowed. I recognize the significant steps ahead and that the important role that our Senate plays in confirming the nominees. And I very much look forward to meeting with as many senators as I am able in the coming weeks as they consider my nomination. And I fully recognize and understand the role they play, and I really look forward to those discussions with them. And I'd also like to thank, Governor mentioned, the Judicial Selection Commission. We have, as you all know, a three-step process. The Judicial Selection Commission is the first step in that process, and they play such an important role in vetting all of the applicants. And there really were a number of wonderful applicants. I'm so glad that Governor Green took the time to talk about those who also made the list, because if one thing I'm proud about being a part of this process is that the governor had a wonderful list of candidates from which to choose. And I know all of them. I think extremely highly of all of them. So thank you, Governor, for sharing those words about the other candidates. As Governor Green mentioned, I'm a product of public schools and tremendously proud of that. I'm a Kailua High School surf rider. I want to say aloha to all of my friends in the community there. You know, a number of them who I still treasure as longtime, lifetime friends. So I appreciate all of them so much. I want to take this time to appreciate my family and close friends who have supported me with love, tremendous love for a long time in life and in my career. And without them, I think they all know I would not be here today. Doing something like this is not really possible without the support of family and friends. So I appreciate that. And I think as Governor mentioned, more than a few of them wrote to him. So you may have met some of my family and friends in writing, at least. I thank them for taking the time to do that, as well as many colleagues over the years who I've worked with or perhaps had cases against. I've heard that a number of folks took the time to share, you know, their knowledge and their thoughts with the governor, and that certainly is a very important part of this, you know, vetting of candidates and making sure that those who are in the positions of making the decisions have the information that is necessary for making these choices. If I could also finally just say I've been privileged to be a part of the Intermediate Court of Appeals for 13 years now, over 13 years. And it's just a wonderful group of judges, staff attorneys, judicial assistants. My judicial assistant is here today, a big part of my life and team. And I want to thank Nadine Grace for being here. And we have a number of other court staff, and the folks at the ICA work so hard day in, day out. And perhaps some of them are watching. I just want to thank them so much for all that they do. And I know that they're steps ahead, but you know, my life and that part of my career will always stay with me. They do a great work, and they're a great team, wonderful collegiality. So with that, I just will say I look forward to the steps ahead. And Governor, I'm so thankful to you. Mahalo for everything. Thank you.
Mahalo, Justice Nominee Ginoza. Now, I would like to introduce Associate Justice Nominee Vladimir Devens. Mr. Devens graduated from the University of California, Berkeley School of Law, and currently serves as principal at the law offices of Vladimir P. Devens, LLC, and has been a partner at Meheula and Devens, Weiner Meheula and Devens. He is also a member of the disciplinary board of the State Supreme Court, and is on the board of the nonprofit Crime Stoppers Honolulu, Inc. Please welcome Mr. Devens to the podium.
Good morning to you all. I'm truly honored and humbled with this appointment to the Hawaii Supreme Court. I want to thank the governor for having the confidence in me to appoint me to the state's highest court. Thank you, Governor. Also to the Judicial Selection Commission for selecting me as a finalist that led to this appointment, and also to the many judges, lawyers, and members in our community for the letters of support and for taking the time to encourage me throughout this process. I was born and raised in Hawaii, and like Judge Ginoza, I'm a product of Hawaii's school system. I'm very thankful for the education that this community gave to me. And should the State Senate confirm me as a State Supreme Court Associate, I will bring to the court the same hard work, commitment, dedication, excitement, and belief in our Constitution and in our court that has marked my decades of work as a litigator. I embark on this new chapter of my career, and with the State Senate willing, I believe I'll bring a very diverse background with many experiences in my legal practice and community work that I'm confident will be a very helpful addition and perspective to Hawaii Supreme Court. I've always been committed to my role under our state constitution and to equal justice under law for all. as required under our state constitution. And last, I'd like to thank my family, my wife Joy, my children, my three daughters, Alexis, Carly, and Lauren, also my parents and my sisters and their families and my in-laws. Thank you very much.
And now I will open up the floor to questions from our reporters gathered here today. I am led to believe that Mr. Blair has the first question, and I'll give him a moment to get his pen.
Thank you. I'm doing double duty as a photographer today. Governor, I can't remember the last time someone who's not currently on the bench actually was appointed to the Supreme Court. In a number of years, I think Mr. Devens does not have any judicial experience in the sense that he hasn't served on the court. You did mention his labor experience and so forth, but what would you say to those who say this is a political pick? You pick someone who's pretty well connected. He worked with Andy Weiner, who's close to you, and to Brian Schatz.
I would say Mr. Devens is just so extraordinarily qualified that it was, again, the many people that recommended him. Former justices, for example, called in. Many former judges called in to recommend Vlad, which surprised me because I didn't realize that he had so many supporters and fans already in the system. I actually looked at this as an opportunity for diversity. I didn't know Vlad until the fall, this past fall at all. I don't think we'd ever met. And it was just a breath of fresh air to have someone with an additional different perspective. Also, I did have concerns that we didn't have enough balanced perspectives on the court, and his experience in the many courtrooms, as he's argued case after case for decades, was helpful. It is true that he had a relationship with, I think, Andy, but it goes back to when they were 20 years old or 22 years old when they were in law school, which I thought was interesting because it's a small world. But I like the diversity. I'm pleased that we have such balance between these two individuals, one who's currently at the top of one of the courts and another who's at the top of his profession as a litigator. So it's just balance all across the spectrum.
Any other questions?
Well, I do have a follow-up.
You can.
Oh, thanks very much. You know, maybe this is for you, but as you know, the justices have to retire at age 70. There was a ballot amendment to try and raise it to 80. There's no age retirement for Supreme Court justices, let alone other politicians. Could you speak to that? Do you think that, would you like to see that change, that a justice or a judge be able to serve beyond age 70?
Yes, in fact, in my previous job as a legislator, I submitted legislation to go to age 75. I would love to see that, but in truth, I don't want to, at this point, meddle further, because whatever governor follows me in the coming years should have the opportunities to do what I have. And this is an incredible honor. So I will leave that to the legislature so that it doesn't appear that I'm acting in a way that would benefit my own opportunity to select so many judges and justices. That's a great question. It was difficult because the other four nominees are incredible people, and so are these two individuals. So that was hard to choose between six great people. But I felt some relief because I'm likely to get the opportunity to nominate at least one more, the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court a couple years from now when the CJ retires, and then several judges at the other levels of the court. So that helped me, because I will tell you, each of the six people merited consideration for either advancement or, I guess, extra props in their own discipline. It's more difficult to deal with the Maui crisis because we've lost loved ones, and some of that can't come back. That is a great challenge. But this is a positive day because I know how much stronger our state gets by having a Supreme Court that these two individuals will be able to match up, you know, blow for blow with how great our two retiring justices are. So we're losing two extraordinary people due to their retirement, and we're adding two extraordinary people through this process. Okay, that's it?
Yeah.
All right, well, look, we have really interesting people. What my team and I have tried to do is to do things a little differently. I think that the questions that were asked reflected that. We don't like status quo. We like to change a little bit. And so I think you actually, in some ways, get a change agent in Vlad Devens, who has such respect in the community, and then incredible experience from Lisa Ginoza. So we're very proud of these picks, and we'll be humbly asking for their support. There's a lot of big challenges on our horizon. These two individuals, when you get to talk to them over time, they will tell you that I did not query them on specific positions, how they would or wouldn't support our administration. I simply asked them to bring their values and morals to this office, because Hawaii, I want to see us move together irrespective of ideology. I want to see us move together based on good works and compassion. That's what you get from these two nominees, and I'm just very happy that they were with us today. Aloha.